Hello everyone. In the last video we have seen, I have given you the general introduction of actually what we are going to study in this particular subject, that is Introduction to Management and Function. So this is the second lecture. We are going to start this module 1 of this particular subject. By the end of this module, you will learn you will be coming to know about the introduction to management. It's the concept of this particular term, that is management, then definition of the management, and what are the different functions of the management we are going to learn. Then the second point is the different levels of the management which you are going to see in an organization, and what are the skills and the roles a manager should have to manage a particular department of which he is heading up to. Then what is the management process, then school of management thoughts. As we have already discussed, that this particular concept of management, it has not come in the 18th century or 19th century. It has been this concept of management has come long back, and we are going to study actually the school of management thoughts, then pre-scientific, classical, behavioral, and modern. Then these are the different schools of management thoughts we will come across into in this module. Then the different types of business organizations which you find here, and what are the advantages, that is the merits and demerits we are going to study, and the public organization. So these are the things which by the end of the module the students are, you all will be learning these things after the completion of this module. So let us start. As you can see, what is management? So as the word actually can see, you can see over here the first three alphabets, that is man means a human being, a person. Okay, so here in this word, when we take into account the first six alphabets, that is manage. Okay, so what I am trying to say is a person who manages, clear, a particular set of activities, or a person who can manage, we can call him as a manager. So using this, a manager who uses some principles in order to carry out, or in order to run an organization, or in order to run his day-to-day life, core activities. So ultimately he is using the concept of management. So what actually I am trying to say here is, as you can see, the managers are the executive function of the organization. Now here, the whoever is in the post of the manager, he is actually is carrying out the executive function of that particular organization, and his most important work is to build and coordinate the entire system. So whoever the persons or the employees who are the part of that organization, the main work of the manager is to bring all the subordinates working under the manager under one umbrella. That means there should be a coordination. If there is no coordination between the subordinates, then he is the person, the manager is the person who should bring that particular culture of coordination in between the subordinates, such that the organization should not face any kind of problem. So to bring coordination in the entire system, the concept of management is used. Now here the management is concept is used to create systems and conditions that enable others to perform those tasks. Now you have to create a particular system. So the person who is working in an organization, who is a part of the organization, he has to work under a particular system. So the organization or the head of the organization is going to create a particular kind of work culture or work system, and he has to work under some conditions which has been created by the organization head. So under the set of some rules and conditions or environmental conditions or in and around conditions, how the particular subordinates has to work, that is called management. So ultimately, a person when he joins in an organization, he has to work as per the organization rules and regulations. He should not work on his own by creating his own rules and regulations. So next one is management creates a right system and environment, and here the managers who are the persons who are ensuring that the organization or the department which is a part of the organization will survive and thrive. So the manager or the persons himself who are coming under this particular organization, they should create that kind of environment such that that particular department or that particular persons who are present in the department or who are the part of the organization, they should survive. Okay. And one more important role of the management is to recognize the key role of the people. Now remember, the manager or the management, he should or he or she should understand actually the person when he joins an organization, he is actually fit to a particular role. See, every person has he is actually what I'm trying to say over here is he is having some skills in a particular area. One person may be good in doing a particular work. So being a manager or being a person under a part of the management group, he should identify, the manager should identify the subordinate or the person who is working under the manager or who is working in the organization. He is capable of doing a particular kind of work in the most efficient way and effective way. So there are many persons who have given different definitions of management, but I have taken two persons where one is Mary Parker Follett, where according to him, management is defined as the art of getting the things done through people. If being an individual, if you have that particular art of getting the job done through other people, then you can say that you are a manager and you have that management ability or managerial qualities. That means if you want that your subordinate or if you want and if you have the ability to make the work done by other person, okay, then you can say you have the management qualities. And according to Mary Parker, he says that management can be defined as the art of getting the things done through people. Now, as per Peter Drucker, he says that management gives a direction to their organization. That means if there is a manager, if the organization is run by a proper management technique, Peter Drucker, he thinks that we got a particular way or a path or a particular direction has been given to that particular organization, irrespective of whatever organization it is, maybe educational organization, financial sector organization, any kind of organization. And due to this management, we can provide leadership. That means we can create leaders who can run the organization in a better way. And the mo one and most important thing is whatever the goals that has been fixed by the organization goals has to be accomplished. You see, it has to be accomplished by keeping in mind that The organizational resources should be utilized in a most efficient way. That means without any wastage. Okay, so as per Peter Drucker, he says that management gives a particular direction, it provides leadership, and management decides how to utilize the organizational resources in a better way without wasting it. And all these things, we are doing it to accomplish the goals. And every organization has a goal. Okay. So, in the next slide, we'll be seeing the different management key concepts. Now, in this particular management key concepts, we'll see about the different terms which we will come across throughout this particular subject. So these actually words which you will use every now and then, you will be finding that I'll be using these terms. So before going to the actual subject, so let us learn some key organizational concepts or key terms which will be beneficial and which you should remember throughout this while learning this particular subject. First one is organization. What is an organization? So people, you have seen your own college is an organization where many people are working together, and there is a kind of coordination in between the people who are working in that organization. And why there should be a coordination, why they are working, ultimately they are working to achieve a particular goal, and that goal should be specific in nature. Okay, specific in the sense, you cannot say that after 1 year I'll be in this particular position, after 1 year I will be in a multinational company. See, every organization, it should have a specific goal. Okay, you should not take 10 goals at a time or 10 number of goals at a time, that by saying that after 1 year I'll be achieving out of 10 any 5 goals. No. So you should, if you are fixing that these 10 goals has to be achieved after 1 year, so all these 10 goals has to be achieved. So you should be specific. You should be specific when you're choosing your organizational goals. So to achieve that organizational goals, all the people who are working, they should have a coordination in that organization. Okay, so the people working together, having coordination between them to achieve a specific goal. Okay, and that is called an organization. Then what is goal? Okay, so goal is it is futuristic condition. That means this goal, whatever you're fixing, that you're fixing it as a specific goal, and goal you can define it as desired. You see, desired means the goals you're desiring it, the goals has not been achieved yet so far. So what I'm trying to, the things that you're desiring to do in future, that is called goal. So a desired future condition which the organization wants to achieve, that is called as a goal. I hope it's clear to you what is organization and what is goal. Next is management. Now, the next term, these organization, goal, management, these are the terms which we'll be using in very often while we are doing this particular course of IMF. Now, next is management. The process of using, what is management? See, management means it's a process. It's a process where you are using the organizational resources to achieve the organizational goals. Now, sir, then there may be a doubt that what are organizational resources? Always remember, in management, the management word starts with letter M. Similarly, the different organizational resources means we are talking about 4 M's. So what are those 4 M's? The first M is machinery, the second M is manpower, the third M is material or raw material, the fourth one is money. So organizational resources includes machinery, manpower, material, money. So these are the four M's which are required to run an organization. You take any organization, whether it is small size organization, medium size organization, or you can say a large size organization where the production capacity is more, where they are earning more and more profits. In that case, what actually happens is in every organization, you name any organization, educational organization, pharmaceutical organization, or it can be a textile industry, textile organization, or any processing organization you can take. So, okay, any type of financial institution, banking sector, banking organization, you name any organization, these four M's will be there: machinery, manpower, material, and money. Okay, so you see, the persons who can utilize these four M's in the best way, that means in the most effective way, that means in the most productive way, without wasting even a single 1% of these four M's, you can say that that particular organization is running in the most effective way. So you see, to run these four M's, if you can run it by using a particular management process and by using these four M's, you are going to achieve a organizational goal. Okay, so these four M's, if you can utilize, and who is going to utilize in the better way these four M's? There is one more M that is called as a manager. So manager also is again starting with the letter M. Okay, so it's a kind of coincidence. So these four M's will be well utilized by the manager and by a particular process. Again, this whole things. Okay, so the organization needs a manager to achieve these specific goals by utilizing these four M's. So that is again called as starting with the letter M, that is management. Okay, so next is number four, organizational performance. So what is performance? How can you calculate, or how can you weight, or how can you say that the organization is performing in a most efficient way? So the managers who are using the resources in the most effective way and in the most efficient way, okay, so then you can say that in order, why they are using, you see, the most important thing is the persons who are using the resources. The resources means we are talking about the four M's. If they're using it in the most effective way, when I talk about, that means we have to use it, we should know that where the machinery, at what time you should use it, which manpower, at what time, which person has to be allotted, which particular job, a particular person will be good in a particular area. So you should give that particular work to that particular person such that the work will be completed in a specific time. Then money, where how well you have to utilize it without wasting the raw materials. So that is called effectiveness. Efficient means with minimum resources you should be able to get the maximum output. The other name is, you can say it as one more term also you can say, which we name it as a productivity. Okay, so why we are doing all this thing is in order to satisfy the customers who are present in the market. Clear? And the customers will be satisfied if the organization is achieving its specific goals. And next term is efficiency, fifth term. Okay, so what is efficiency? It is a measurement how well the resources are used. That is what I'm saying. Efficiency, the other term, is also called as productivity. Clear? And productivity is actually, you can say productivity is output by input into 100. That means what is input? Input, we are talking about, input is all the resources. It can be raw material, it can be machinery, or it can be the money, or it can be the manpower. So if input is minimum, ultimately what will happen, if input is minimum, the productivity will increase. That is a simple concept. If the denominator is as less and less, then the productivity will increase. That means we have to effectively utilize the natural resources or the organizational resources that we are having. Okay, so how well you are utilizing the resources in order to achieve the goal, that is called as efficiency. And the last term is effectiveness. Remember, effectiveness means it is a measurement of how appropriate the goals that you have chosen are correct. You see, if you, I'll give you a simple example, that is, if you have, that means if you have a organizational goal that after completion of these 4 years, I will become a CEO of the company. You see, there are, you can say, this is not, this particular goal cannot be measured. That means you should not choose a goal which is immeasurable. Immeasurable in the sense, there should not be an organizational goal that I will start a company which on the first day or maybe after 1 month or 1 year it will compete with Reliance Industries. So those type of inappropriate goals you should not fix for a organization being a manager. So it is, effectiveness means how well the organizational goals that you are choosing, how appropriate it is. That means whether if you are giving, if it is a time bound organizational goal which you want to achieve. Okay, so it is not that if after 1 year your organizational goal should be completed. It is not that after 1 year you are going to achieve only 20% or 30% of that particular organizational goal. That means when you are choosing the goal, you have not chosen in the most appropriate way. Clear? So what I am trying to speak is, whatever organizational goal that you have fixed it, whether until what degree you can achieve it. So that is called as, that calculation is called as effectiveness. So you should be very careful when you are choosing the organizational goals. So these are the six things or six management key concepts which these terms which we will be using every now and then throughout this particular subject, that is organizational goals, management, organizational performance, organizational assets, organizational resources, then effectiveness, then efficiency, organizational efficiency or productivity, effectiveness. So these are all the six important terms which we will be using in our day-to-day life. Now in the next class or in the next lecture, we will be reading about the main introduction to management. As already I told you, what is introduction to management, we'll be studying in the next class. Okay, I hope you have understood whatever that has been taught. Okay.